Coming up on this episode of Blind Kitchen, it's a battle between two Puerto Rican chefs as Chelsea's Calixto David of Cooking with Cali takes on a personal chef and instructor from Lowell, Tanya Nicole. Will Tanya's tasty spin on a Puerto Rican classic be enough to trip up Cali?
You doing my plate justice?
Yeah.
We'll see about that.
Or will Cali's overconfidence give Tanya an opening to impress the judges?
So you feel confident that you know what it is?
Yeah.
What else are you thinking?
What else?
We'll find all that out and more on this episode of Blind Kitchen.
Welcome to Blind Kitchen. I'm Beamy Cruz. Today, we're at the Revolving Test Kitchen in Lawrence, Massachusetts. We have two talented local chefs that we're gonna put to the test. What do you say we get things started?
I felt like I couldn't lose. I could showcase what I could do. It's a new challenge, like, why not? Blind taste testing? Come on down.
You have to guess and play with somebody's mind what you did and what you guessed. That's all that counts, and I like that.
Thank you both for being on the show. I'd like to welcome Tanya Nicole, personal chef from Lowell, Massachusetts, and Calixto David, chef, owner of Cooking with Cali from Chelsea, Mass.
Sir.
Tanya, tell me a little bit more about yourself.
My name is Chef Tanya Nicole. I'm a personal chef and a nutritionist. I'm from Lowell, Massachusetts, and I've been cooking since I was 12. I went to culinary school at Johnson & Wales, and I have a culinary nutrition degree from there. I also worked throughout my career and in college with the Community Service Center, and there they have programs where we work in the food pantries, we work in after-school programs, we work at senior centers. I call myself the food gypsy because I'm always doing like a million things. Usually they have to do with food. The other client is nutrition, the other client is meal prep. The other client wants me to do catering. Food is everything. It's food for your body, it's food for your brain, but it's food for your soul. What's better than that?
That is awesome. So Cali, can you tell me a little bit about yourself?
I'm Calixto David Jr. I'm the chef owner of Cooking with Cali in Chelsea, Massachusetts. I was born in Puerto Rico, flew out here with my parents when I was 1 month. My mother's like, she used to work so much that she wasn't home. There was nothing to be cooked. So she started teaching me. Then after school, there was a Boys and Girls Club. I used to go to Jordan Chelsea Boys and Girls Club. They taught me how to cook a couple things with their kitchen. When I would go home, I would tell Ma, what are the seasonings you would put on this and that? And I would bring that back to the Boys and Girls Club. I got into my 20s, COVID hit in Chelsea, everything was just shut down. I see that a lot of people were like, hey, I need sofrito. So I started making it again. And then it was just the full catering. It started a great thing for me. I started working with the city hall. I started doing Papawana for the kids, teaching them how to cook different Latin flavors. I go and that's what I do. I love what I do, cooking.
What are you hoping to gain from the experience of this show?
A friendly competition. I got to know a brand new chef. We all just stay connected.
So a sense of community.
Yes.
That's awesome. I'm very excited to see how it's all gonna shake down. Before we start, let's go over the rules. So your goal is simple. Cook an original dish and serve it to the other chef. You'll taste each other's dish and try to figure out their ingredients. After that, you'll recreate the other chef's original dish. Simple, right? But there's a catch. You'll be tasting the opposing chef's signature dish blindfolded. You'll have to figure out how it's plated, what the ingredients are, and how it's cooked by only taste, smell, and touch. The winner of the competition is determined by the percentage of the correct ingredients, similarities in flavor and plating, and how the recreated dish stands on its own. And if you win, we'll make a donation to a local charity of your choice in your name. Cali, are you gonna be cooking or tasting first?
I'll be cooking first. Scope.
Good luck.
My style is old school Puerto Rican. Indigenous, like in the people that live in the mountains and stuff like that, the way we used to live. Today I made jibarito. It's like a hamburger. Jibarito is made out of plantains. You just take out the buns and you put squash plantain, then you put your lettuce, tomatoes, onions, whatever you decide, with a splash of mayo ketchup and your flank steak. And fried yuca, that's one of the Puerto Rican delicacies, that's all we eat out there. It's like a little sandwich. That's what I brought to the table today.
All right, so we're back. Chef Cali, you finished preparing your dish. Tanya, put on that blindfold.
When the blindfold first went on, I was like, I cannot see anything. I think that was the moment that it hit me. I'm really just going with the wind here.
Cali, reveal your dish. Your clock starts now.
I think I was happy knowing that it was a Puerto Rican chef. I'll be at least familiar with some of the flavors.
Really crunchy on the outside. I can hear that it's crunchy, a little salty. I guess it's savory. Maybe a plantain, maybe a yuca.
Maybe a plantain, maybe a yuca.
I wasn't sure between the tostones, which are fried green plantains, and yuca. They both had very similar textures.
I think it's a green plantain, I think. I feel like yuca will have more stringiness to it.
Okay, let's keep moving our hands around. We're down to 3 minutes and try to figure out what we got here.
Okay. Kind of feels like it's something layered. So that's definitely lettuce, maybe. Oh, tomato. Protein here. It's tough to pull.
Trying to get all the notes, the smell, the texture.
So maybe not chicken.
You're gonna miss something.
It's good.
Well, that's always a good thing.
It's like maybe like a flank steak or something.
So you're thinking flank steak? So now you're down to 15 seconds. Don't be afraid to get your hands dirty. Just
no, not
figure
at all.
It out.
That's what chefs do. We get it all dirty.
What do you think you have in your hand right now?
Like a plantain sandwich.
And then you described the sauce as, you said it was
It's a mayo ketchup, very traditional Puerto Rican condiment.
I'm surprised she got all of it. Like, she got all of them correct. She didn't slip up on one.
Onion.
That was covered. I saw it go in her mouth. She was like, onion. I was like, she got it. I was like, damn.
Time's up. Let's cover it back up.
I can't wait till it's your turn.
So talk to me, Tanya. How did that go for you?
It was really interesting. I think I could figure out that there's like some sauce on the side, and it seemed like it was layered.
So how confident do you feel in you being able to recreate that?
That's a whole nother story.
Are you ready to present a challenge for Chef Cali?
Definitely. Let's do it. I made a mofongo with a chicken and calabaza caldo, which is a Caribbean pumpkin. Mofongo is a starch, so that you want something kind of moist to add to that starch. I made a mojo sauce, which is just garlic and olive oil sauteed, very like slow and low.
This is a classic Puerto Rican dish. If you go to a restaurant, you will find mofongo on the menu. I'm gonna serve it with a nice piece of chicken, although you don't have to.
I plated the sauce or the caldo around it. Chef Cali sends me a message on Instagram. He had all these pictures of mofongo, and I was like, oh, he'll be able to like figure out what it is easily, and he'll be able to make something good.
All right, so we're back. Tanya, you finished cooking. Cali, let's get that blindfold on.
You have to use all senses, feet, smell, hearing. No, it was crazy.
So you ready?
Ready.
Reveal that dish. You got 5 minutes, the clock starts now.
Even though the plate was right in front of me, you don't see where nothing is.
What are your initial thoughts?
Oh, it's chicharrón. Oh, man.
Okay, so you have chicharrón in mind?
No. Once I felt it, I knew.
What are you doing right now? Did you just lick it? What are you doing right now? Did you just lick it?
I'm trying to lick it because it's like garlicky. I'm trying to see if she got like some garlic infused, some oils. When I felt the texture of the mofongo and I tasted the garlic, I was like, that's a mofongo. I thought she saw my Instagram. Why would she do that? Oh my God.
Thank you.
That skin is phenomenal. You know that one friend be like, oh, don't eat this skin. I'm eating this. Oh, man, yeah. This is what it is. Chicken mofongo.
Chicken mofongo?
Once I felt the mofongo, I was like, I'm the master of this.
All right, so you got 30 seconds now. You feel confident that you know what it is?
Yeah.
And what else are you thinking?
What else?
Is there any anything?
Yes, but I can't get it. I should have lick the plate, you know?
You're confident you can recreate it?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's your time right there. Let's cover it up.
Oh, that chicken's
good. Okay, I'll make you some chicken.
What was the most challenging part about tasting this blindfolded?
When you feel the meat, you're like, what meat? Could it be this and that? Once I had a grip of the skin, ain't no other meat that rips off like that.
Well, chefs, I'm going to try both of your amazing dishes. I can't wait to see your spin on these dishes. So before these chefs recreate these dishes, let's break them down and find out what some of the challenges are going to be. Chef Cali created here a traditional jibarito sandwich. Let's start with these yuca fries. They have a nice, crunchy bite, but have a nice, creamy texture in the inside. And this is one of the things that Tanya was tripped up on. What she was thinking, whether it's plantains or yuca, so she was in the ballpark. Sometimes yuca fries, they're more thinner, and the way he decided to make it is the reason why I feel that she was tripped up. When it comes to the sandwich, you take a fried plantain and you flatten it out, and that takes the place what normally would be bread on a sandwich. Let's dip this into the mayo ketchup as intended and see how this is overall as one solid bite. I can tell you one thing, he nailed it and he knocked it out the park. The question is, can she do the same? So let's go over to Chef Tanya's dish. What we have here is a traditional mofongo. Chef Cali was able to pick up on that right away. He was also able to pick up on the chicken. Let's see if the way that Chef Cali described it is as good as it looks. Mmm. It has just the right amount of crunch and packed with flavor. And he also figured out the chicharrón. And again, Chef Cali praised that chicharrón, and he was spot on. That chicharrón is absolutely fabulous. Let's dig into this mofongo. The mofongo, right away, has excellent flavor. It has a nice touch of garlic that you get right away, but at the same time, it dances in your palate, but it doesn't overpower it. One thing that I felt that Chef Cali was missing was pinpointing this sauce. This sauce is absolutely amazing. The squash adds a bit of sweetness to this that makes it different from any other regular savory or rich sauce. Let's see if he's gonna be able to put this together and present us a beautiful mofongo with also a beautiful sauce. Chefs, you have 45 minutes on the clock and your time starts now.
You want it to be a competition.
It's just not like a cooking, oh, here, you're better than me, blah, blah, blah. No, you have to guess and play with somebody's mind. Like, you have to get the right ingredients. Recreate all this. Never underestimate nobody.
You ready, Chef Cali? You ready?
Let's
do this.
Let's
do
this,
baby. My plate justice?
Yeah.
We'll see about that. The Puerto Rican culinary world is very small, so anytime you can make connections with someone, that's great.
It's all about the flavor, you say, right?
You mean you don't normally cook everything in 45 minutes?
Nah.
I'm so distracted, I was grinding the salt the other way.
Chef, how we doing? And what do you got going on over here?
Chicharrón, chicken, which I believe to be on the plate. The chicken, I've been having that since I was a little kid. Automatically, like, it was, I felt my heart, boop. It's mofongo. Nobody can tell me it's not. And the chicken, nobody can tell me it's not.
It almost looks as good as mine.
Okay.
Almost.
Okay.
Chef, how are we doing?
We're doing good.
What do you think is gonna be the most challenging thing for you to recreate?
Making the flavors just as good as Chef Cali, if not better.
If not better.
If not better. If not better. I have never made this dish before.
Well,
if it's what I think it is, we'll see. I know how to fry a plátano, but that's a big plátano, so we'll see how it comes out. You have a plan, but 30 minutes goes by so fast.
35, 40 minutes, and that's when you think easy, and that's when you're wrong. So you have to have something ready to go, or if not, the time's up.
Kelly, talk to me. How are we looking, brother?
Man, look at this color right here, Chef.
That actually looks amazing.
I was going for it. My mind was already set.
We talked about a sauce. Do you have a plan for a sauce for this? We talked about a sauce. Do you have a plan for a sauce for this?
To be honest, I do not know what that sauce is. I tried it. I'm going with my heart, whatever I can do right here.
Once you finish this, you still got plenty of time on the clock. Let's keep that in mind and see if there's anything that we could put together that comes close to that.
Oh.
10 minutes. I got this.
I'm making sure the plantain is cooked so I can make this little sandwich that I think we got going on.
Feeling confident? You got 10 minutes left to finish everything you got going on right now.
Probably need to double fry them. If I can make at least 2 sandwiches, I can always cut them in half if I have to, because we want something on the plate.
It's time to kick it into gear. We need to make sure that these dishes are ready to go. Let's stop pushing this and getting these plates ready to go. Four, 3, 2, 1, hands up. Good job, guys. Good job. Chefs, it has been a tough competition. To help me come up with a decision today, we have Natalie Rodriguez, chef owner of Nuestra Restaurant in Worcester, Massachusetts. Can you please tell me more about yourself and the restaurant?
I am Puerto Rican myself. You know, we do innovative things at my restaurant. So we do Puerto Rican cuisine, grandma's cooking, grandma's flavor, but a little bit of a modern twist. So I'm super excited to dig in and see what you guys got today.
So what do you say we try Tanya's reinterpretation of Callie's dish?
Let's do it.
I see what you're working right. I'm gonna try your sauce. So Callie, talk to me. What do you think after your first initial bite?
I like the way the plantain is set. It's not too hard. It's not too soft, it's like perfect.
You think she did the sauce some justice?
I felt like she did a little bit more garlic.
A little bit more garlic?
Yeah.
People think that it's easy, but it's really not that easy. You have to balance that garlic just right. So I think you did a great job. I think the only thing that I would say on the plate would be you didn't even need the mayo ketchup in the bottom, because then my hands were like messy when I went to go pick it up.
Yes, chef.
But besides that, I think it was very good.
Tanya.
Yes, chef.
Are you ready to try Callie's version of your dish?
I'm definitely ready. The chicken looks amazing.
So let's dig in.
Let's try it. I'm gonna give it the Chef Callie test and eat the skin first.
So I guess we all should do that. Let's give this the Callie. Great flavor, nice crunch. And I feel like that's something that us Puerto Ricans hardly ever miss on, and this definitely didn't miss. How do you feel Callie did in recreating your dish?
I think he did a really good job. The sauce is like a different color. I think it's like a little butter and a little garlic. The difference is that I put the chicharron on top, yeah, and he put it inside the plátano. Mm-hmm. And sometimes when you do that, the moisture gets in. Mm-hmm. So there's like pieces that are really great of the chicharron, and there's like a couple little.
I would have like cilantro on the dish instead of parsley.
You know, there's a million things we would have done differently, but I think he did an amazing job. I think his plating was even better than mine.
It seems like me and Natalie have a tough decision on our hands. So give us a few minutes to deliberate, and I'm confident we'll come up with the decisions.
Came here and executed what I had to do. It's funny, because nowadays you don't find people like that. You see, some people don't even, they be isolated. They don't want to talk to you. Win or lose, I loved just coming here, being here.
Well, Natalie, it seems we have a tough decision on our hands. What are your initial thoughts after trying Tanya's recreation of Callie's dish?
Well, my initial thoughts are meat is really, really flavorful. I feel like the cut of meat was too thick.
Yes.
Personally, I would have cut it in small and stewed it up so that it would be nice and soft. It's nothing worse than trying to like tear through a piece of steak. You know,
absolutely.
The steak nice for a reason. And, yeah. But everything else on the plate, you know, the mayo ketchup was flavorful. The plantains were also seasoned as well,
yes,
which is good and it's important.
Another thing about this dish that you might not be aware of, that Callie's original dish came with a side of yuca fries. Tanya thought that they were plantain fries. But after recreating the dish, she just completely left the fries out. It's one of those things that it was vital to the dish that made the dish come together. The mayo ketchup was good, but I feel it's slightly over-seasoned. I felt a little bit too much salt. Overall, did she execute at the end of the day? Maybe not, but part of this is making sure that you can recognize the ingredients when you do your blind test. Meanwhile, what are your thoughts when it comes to Callie's dish?
For me, it was plated very well. The mofongo is a classic, and so I felt the flavors were there. I did agree with Chef Tanya about the pieces of the chicharrón inside just being a little soggier. However, the crispiness of the chicken was great. The seasoning on the skin was amazing, which those are the little things that you look for anyways. I would have liked a little bit more flavor inside of the sauce that he put.
This dish has some flavors that really are outstanding. The crispiness of that skin was next level. The flavor on that chicken was delicious. The sauce was also a delicious sauce. My only issue is that is way left field from the sauce that she put together. She roasted some pumpkin squash, she mixed it in with that recao, which is culantro, and she had some garlic, and she made a beautiful velvety broth that took this mofongo and elevated it to the next level. Although he had beautiful crispiness on the skin of that chicken, he lost a bit when it came to the crispiness of the chicharrón.
I think the time to throw me off with the dish, I feel like it needed just some cilantro.
So both chefs did an amazing job, but I think we came up with a decision. Let's bring the chefs back in. Thank you for participating today in Blind Kitchen. You both made amazing dishes. You made this very difficult for me and Natalie, but we came up with a decision. Natalie, can you announce the winner?
Yes, super difficult, guys. You guys did an amazing job. Everything was very flavorful, and it was really, really hard to make this decision. And the winner is Chef Tanya.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Like, I was genuinely surprised. I really did think that Chef Cali was going to win.
Congratulations, Chef Tanya. You did an amazing job. Since you came out on top, what charity will you be donating to?
I'm going to be donating to Rosie's Place. It's a charity very close to my heart. It serves women and children who are in some kind of a struggle or need, and they serve them in various ways.
That's awesome. Well, congratulations again. Chef Cali, everything you did today was absolutely amazing.
Thank you, thank you.
And that sauce was the only thing missing, but it was also the highlight of the day.
It sunk, and then I was like, yo, that's what's up. She worked harder than me, and I have to put my chin up and start making squash sauces.
Natalie, thank you for helping with this tough decision, and good luck with Nuestra restaurant in Worcester, Massachusetts. And I hope you join us here next time when two more local chefs go head-to-head in Blind Kitchen. Thanks for watching.